Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum everyone. Welcome to Amazed by the Qur'an, a series in which I'd like to share with you what I find amazing about the Qur'an. Today I'll be sharing with you two ayat that belong to the same surah. They belong to Surah At-Tawbah, and in comparing these two ayat, we're going to see how Allah, in a very subtle and beautiful way, emphasizes the power of heaven, of which reward of heaven is greater. So I'll begin with the first one. This is the 100th ayah. وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ تَبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ وَأَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ أَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي تَحْتَهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. Those, the first and the foremost who came forward among those who migrated and those who aided, meaning the Meccans and the Medinans. وَالَّذِينَ تَبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ, all of those that have followed them with excellence, may Allah make us from them. رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ, Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with Him. وَأَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي تَحْتَهَا الْأَنْهَارِ, and He's prepared for them gardens at the bottoms of which rivers flow. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا, they will stay in it forever. ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ, that is the ultimate success. Another ayah from the same surah, Allah says, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. Allah has promised believing men and believing women gardens at the bottoms from right underneath them rivers flow. So the previous ayah was, they flow from underneath, but this is right underneath, meaning right at their feet the river is originating. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا, in which they will remain, وَمَسَاكِنَ طَيِّبَةً, and good and pure, suitable homes that they can find tranquility in. فِي جَنَّاتِ عَدْنٍ, in the gardens of Eden. Previously we were told gardens, now we're being told gardens of Eden, جَنَّاتِ عَدْنٍ, so this additional meaning of عَدْنٍ. وَرِضْوَانٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرٍ, and great contentment that they will feel from Allah, meaning Allah is incredibly pleased with them, and that is even greater than all of the rewards previously described. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ, that in fact is the ultimate success. So you find this really small shift. You have ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ, which is, that is the ultimate success, or that's the great success, versus ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ, that is in fact the ultimate success. There's an additional huwa, the dhamir, and what that does is it adds an emphatic tone to this ayah as opposed to the other ayah, both belonging to the same surah. Now if you compare the two rewards of Jannah, you'll find that in this case, what Allah has done, in fact, is He's offered, first of all, gardens that are more intense in their reward, because rivers aren't just flowing beneath your feet, they start from right under your feet. So this is actually the idea of ibtida. You're standing at the top of a waterfall where it starts, where it springs. The other thing about, you know, beautiful homes, in the previous ayah you saw that, you know, Allah has promised gardens, but that there's no more description. But here, and in the previous ayah, Allah did say that they are, Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with Allah. But here He said a great contentment, ridwan, the noun is used, which is a kind of permanence and, you know, transcendence. The great contentment that they will enjoy from Allah is greater, akbar. It's greater. It's in fact that Allah is describing that the way Allah will be pleased with them is greater than any other reward they've ever experienced. And once He gets to that, He says, ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. That in fact is the ultimate success. He adds in huwa to this. The point of subtlety and the point that amazes me about these two ayat is they're about 16, 17 ayat apart. Meaning Allah is giving a speech, He says something, 16, 17 ayats later He says something similar. And while you're speaking, to be cognizant of the fact that I described Jannah, and I described it in more emphatic tone, so, and that was a more emphatic context in which I described something that is far more powerful, and now I'm describing something that is not nearly as powerful, so I should tone it down by just one pronoun. That kind of conscience in speech is impossible. That's just impossible. I can't keep track of what I said and how much I emphasized something. You know, people remember, for instance, think about it like this, people remember what they say, but it's very hard to remember how emphatically they said it. Maybe I remember I saying I was tired. Maybe I don't remember saying, man, I'm really tired. The added emphasis, I just don't remember, I'm not conscious of it. Maybe you can get me to recall, I think I did say something like I was tired, right? My exact words are impossible to remember, even from like 20 minutes ago. It's because people say, my exact words were, and then you play the video and those weren't their exact words. That's their own speech. And that's not even years ago or months ago or days ago. It's minutes ago. It's minutes ago that they can't recall exactly what they said. The Quran takes into consideration exactly how it speaks. And later on, as it adds even the most subtle nuance, it adjusts the speech and takes into consideration what was said before so it can be compared with what was said after. Allah says similar things in the Quran. If you read English translation, you'll find things are very, very similar, right? Lots of things are repeated. But when you study the Arabic, you'll find that those similar things are actually just a little bit shifted, just a little bit different. And that little difference is actually where the treasure lies, in appreciating the perfection of the kalam of Allah. May Allah Azza wa Jal give us the ability to appreciate His perfect word. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. If you enjoyed this video, please do share it with friends and family. If you want to see more videos from this series, click on the box at the top. If you want to see other videos, click on the box at the bottom. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks.